Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, we are going to review the integration in between Langchain and ElasticSearch, and then we will do a small demo where we use the technology ElasticSearch as a vector store and working as a retriever in a small rack application together with Gemini Pro. So for those who are not familiar with ElasticSearch is an open source distributed RESTful search and analytics engine. So it's a technology that has been done there already for a long time. It's quite mature already in the industry. There's many companies using it. It's based on indexes that you use to store different information among the embeddings of your documents produced by any embedding model that you may want to use, commercial, not commercial, even Elastic has their own models, embedding models, and you can use it, as I said, for many purposes. Usually it has been a search engine, a very well-known search engine for private information that you can deploy it on premises, and today, apart from to be working on premises, is working as well on as a SaaS service on the three main cloud providers. I'm not really sure if it's Alibaba, the Chinese provider, offer it, but Google, Azure, and Amazon offers Elastic Search service as a part of the portfolio of services they have. I used to work a lot with this technology, mostly as a search engine where we create or with the save documents or the extraction of some documents in combination at that time, in this time with Apache Tika, another with this an extraction tool, and well, for today we still don't use the technology as a vector store, but the plan is to do it soon in a short middle term and replace some of the vector stores that we are using currently with ElasticSearch, because it's essentially reducing the complexity of our solutions. As usually, I have created a notebook that later on I will upload to the repo, and you will be able to download it in your local environment and replicate what you are going to see here in this demo. You had for the client side the notebook and my local environment. I will patch you the requirements. Similar to you are following the channel to what we use in previous videos in the where I'm discussing about the rack components, Neo4j, Langchain, etc. The only thing that we need to include is the library, which include the integration Langchain ElasticSearch. From the server side, the engine, today we are going to use a Docker. Again, you can use you can install this in your local environment, on premises, or you can use a deployment in Azure or Google Cloud or whoever. Let me show you. This is, for example, in Azure. You have here, you go to Elastic Cloud, and then you just create one resource, and it's choose the region, name, version, and the consumption plan, pay as you go. The tool is now again open source. It was for a while you need to create it was a licensed product, but again they offer the product Elastic as an open source, and here if you decide to go in with the cloud provider, you will just need to pay for the infrastructure. It's pay as you go. The infrastructure that you dedicate to set up the clusters, ElasticSearch clusters. Okay, so here, we are going to use a Docker. Keep in mind that if you decide later use something similar, here in this Docker you don't have permanent storage, so The Docker itself is just containing the engine, ready to go. You will see how it's just execute or run these three commands that you see here, create the network, pull the Docker, and run the Docker in this network with this name and exposing the 9200 port with 1 GB memory. So, but this is not mapping the index storage of Elasticsearch to a permanent Docker. So if you pretend to do this, you will have to plan to modify the Docker container to and create a permanent storage connected to a permanent resource where to keep the indexes that you will create, and especially like today for a vector store where you don't need to recreate it if you decide to use this technology as a part of a rack component, like something similar to what you will see here. So for the AI, generative AI side, we use Gemini models, the Gemini Pro 1.5 and the embeddings models from Gemini. We use the integration also with Langchain, the library, the object Google, chat Google generative AI and Google generative AI embeddings. I'm using a service principal account generated in Google with access to my Vertex AI endpoint in Google Cloud. And then on, I here just getting my credentials from the JSON file and initializing the API, the access to the API. Additionally, you need access to the Google AI Studio or the previous Gemini Studio. You need the API key to access the embedding models. Here we instantiate our embedding models, and to create the vector store, you just simply point to the URL. In this case, is the localhost. Decide an index names, and you use the embeddings as embedding. User and password no need. And here is the final vector store. You can see I'm not even using it, it's no need for. I'm opening here a document, it's a PDF that I will extract the information from it. It's just simply public information about a company. It's a long document with 143 documents. Pages, sorry. What I will do here is use PyPDF loader to extract the text and create Langchain documents. You can see here, once you use the PDF loader, you load and split the document, you generate approximately one document per page, and the documents contain some metadata with the source, which is the name of the file, and the page where the information is coming from. In page content, you have the text of the page, and this is essentially what you have. You can visualize other. In total, it has been extracted 196 pages, and then on with, in the next logic, we will extract the information to So we will add information to the vector store. We did this similarly to what you do with other technologies. Here we just use the documents, the Langchain documents, and we create a ID for every document using the library UUID. So here we add all the documents. This will cause a lot of traffic here on the logs of your Elasticsearch. Once you are running the Docker, you will get all these logs, a lot of information, and once you have all the information in your vector store, we just use the method addsRetrieval to create the component that later on will be used on the conversational retrieval chain of Langchain. We instantiate the model, chat Google generative AI object with our Gemini 1.5 Pro, and using the credentials that we create before the Vertex AI credentials. Here we instantiate the chain. We from LLM method, LLM, retrieval, and return documents equal true, just to later on review. What is going to happen here when you make an invoke with a query? First of all, Langchain will make a query to the retrieval. It will get, in that case, the five more, the best five or the most relevant documents according or that match with the query that you made, and it will use these five documents as context to finally send your query and these documents to the LLM, and the LLM will use it as context to provide you an answer, as you will see here. So we will try here, we create a link as well to keep our history, the history of the speaking with our RAC component, our chain. So we ask for some information that is contained on the document. And then on, you will see here, you can review the document. This is on the first page, essentially. Let me show you just to verify. You can use your own document. This is just an example. You see here, name, country, company, incorporated, accounting days, compliance days. So now we add here, you can visualize what you get as response, the question, the history, which in the first call is empty, the answer, and the source documents. The source documents are LEMFIGHT. This is the documents, and you can visualize here what essentially means that. This is five documents that the Langchain retrieve from Elastic, just to be used as context. What they use as context is essentially the page content, what is contained on the page content attribute of the document. Okay, so next we just add the query and the answer to the chat history, and we make a second question, which is the management details. Is this case blah blah blah? Yeah, Caroline McPackland, and yeah, you can see here a manage by email, blah blah blah. Here we make another, we add a chat to the history, and we add for the past names of the, yeah, you have it here, the past names of the company. I think this is on the second page, past names. You have it Adware construction from 2020 to 2021, and from 2021 to 2020 Adware and Son LTD. Okay, so now we add again the history, and we ask for the appointment board position with this other information. Again, you can try with your own documents. This is not limited. There is no, you can use whatever document. So far, they are PDFs, PDF documents, not scanned PDFs documents. You can use the libraries that you saw here, and there is this is the appointments. You can verify this is in page 3 of my documents, appointments, above. Aberrata, Rattel Gas, exactly, non-executive directors, company secretary. I think he's missing somebody here, Albert Stoffel. Ah, no, he's here. Adam Nicole, yeah. Rutter Gas, yeah, exactly. With the details that you get from here. Okay, that's pretty much all. Pretty simple. We did this exercise several times with other technologies, so you don't expect too much changes here. We just replace the vector store technology, so it's no changes on the model. So you can see that we just replace one of the technologies of the RAC component, and then again it's working. Pretty much the same that you saw before in previous videos, no? And you can see here, even database, yeah. So for embeddings, as I mentioned you before, you can use commercial, non-commercial. You can use as well. Let me put you here this on the documentation because it's an important link with a lot of information that they are in the blocks of the Elastic. Elan is one of the embeddings model that they produce. They also had some trained LLMs that also ElasticSearch produce. You can use commercial, non-commercial, you can use their own, so it's up to you how you want it to integrate it. You have access to those models using Elastic because it's essentially, Langchain, not Elastic. Langchain is a technology which is going to give you access to the embeddings and to the LLM. So the only thing that we are doing here with Elastic is use it as a vector store and later on as a retriever to generate context for the Langchain chain. Okay, that's pretty much all. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find it interesting and useful for whatever reason that you are watching this video, and if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and that's pretty much all. Make comments if you find something that you are struggle to do. Just write me a comment on the comments of the video. I will try to help you to the best of my knowledge. And yeah, share the video with your colleagues or your friends. Make comments and all this stuff. Give me a like, and just to help me to grow YouTube. Thank you very much, and see you soon.